हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे अगेन हेयर आई एम विद अनदर लेक्चर ऑन आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन। दिस टाइम अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दिस मेथड दैट इज नोन एज बॉक्स मेथड टू यू। द प्रॉब्लम वी हैव टेकन ए प्रॉब्लम ऑफ फ्रस्टम ऑफ ए हेक्सागोनल पिरामिड। एज यू नो दैट फ्रस्टम विल बी व्हेन ए पिरामिड विल बी कट बाय ए प्लेन पैरेलल टू द बेस एंड लोअर पार्ट विल बी नोन एज द फ्रस्टम ऑफ द पिरामिड। सो आई एम टेकिंग द फ्रस्टम ऑफ ए पिरामिड whose lower base will be 40 mm side, top base will be 20 mm side and axis will be 60 mm long. Here I have drawn the top view of that frustum of hexagonal pyramid. So this bigger hexagon that is 40 mm side, inside there that will be another small hexagon that is of 20 mm side and these are the slant edges. I have just drawn the top view, not the front view, because for drawing the isometric projection we don't need the front view. The height will be 60 mm given to me. So in box method, what we will do in box method? In box method, normally what we will do, initially we will close the figure, the top view of that object inside a rectangle. As I have already bounded this by a rectangle, this white color portion, and now we will draw a cuboid of this length into this length into height 60 mm. And that will be the box inside which I am going to keep my frustum of hexagonal pyramid. So the easiest way will be, as we know that in isometric it is easiest to draw a cube or a cuboid or a square prism. So at this time actually box will be like a cuboid, and you know that in cuboid all the lines will be isometric lines, so we can easily place those lines on 30, 30 and 90 axis and easily draw the box. So what we have started, again from bottom we will start and select two 30, 30 axes, and this third axis will be at 90. I will place this length, that is this length, length of this side on this line and the length of the opposite side on this line, and this length will be 60 mm, that is the height of the cuboid. After drawing this 1, 2, 3 line, now draw this line parallel to this, this line is also parallel to this, then draw this line parallel to this line, draw this line parallel to this one, and again parallel to this, this line and parallel to this will be this line, and lower part also I have marked. Actually maybe we require one or two points in the bottom side, so I have drawn that by dotted lines. So this is the complete box in which this hexagonal frustum of hexagonal pyramid will be going to be bounded. Now I am going to plot these points. So if I want to plot these points, this A and B, you know that the distance of this A from this corner will be equals to the distance of B from the opposite corner. The same way the distance of the E and the distance of the D. So these four capital points can be directly drawn. So this will be point A, opposite side will be point B, then on this line there we will get the point E, and I don't think I need the backside point, that is D, that may be not required to me, but okay, I will mark that point also. The same way for F point, perpendicular from this, this is the midpoint of this line, so on this line I can mark this point F. And the same way I can mark the point in the opposite. So these are the points. Actually I can name those points. This is my point A, this will be B, this will be F, this will be E, and this point will be the point C, maybe not needed in future, and this is the point D. So I marked all the six points in the bottom parallelogram. Actually the rectangle will be drawn like a parallelogram. Now we want to plot these upper points. If you look at these points, if I draw a line from here passing through this upper line, the same way a line passing through these two points A and B like this, and the third will be this line. so I can easily mark these lines on the upper face. This distance equals to this one. The same way this distance will be equals to this one. So on this, if I mark these lines, one point, then opposite side another point, then opposite side, then on the opposite, then this again midline. So what I have done, I have drawn these three lines in the initially in the orthographic projection, then I have shifted these three lines on the isometric and joined these three lines by thin lines that will be visible to you only like this. So these are the three lines on the upper face. Just check the distances are okay or not. Maybe little bit on the okay. Now on these lines I can mark easily mark these points. This is known as offsetting. Actually I am moving this side this much distance and perpendicular, then I will get the point A, and the distance of A will be the same, that is the distance of E from the opposite corner, that is the distance of the D from the opposite, and distance of the B from the opposite corner. So these all four points will be at the equidistant from the opposite corner. So mark these four points, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again look at these points, this is the distance of small a, small e, small d and small b. Just use the divider or compass and mark these four points. Same way this f, the distance of small f from capital F will be equals to the distance of small c from capital C. So mark these two points on this line. Now already we got all the six points in the top face also. Now I can easily join, if you want to name them, name these points. This will be small a, b, c, d, e and f. Now join these points. Join this D with E. Join all those points. Don't think about what is the shape of the figure. Now in the lower part also we can join this A with B and A with F. Now join this F with small f with capital F like this. Join this small a with capital A and join this small b with, as I already told, there is no use of this point capital C, that is not needed. Then finally this E point will be joined by capital E, and join this E with point F. Now look at the figure, there is no need to draw the backside points, there is no need. If you want to draw, you can draw. In isometric projection we will say that it is not necessary to draw dotted lines. If you feel that it is needed, then you can, but right now I don't think there is a need of drawing those points. So if I little bit lighten this backside portion, remove this one, the figure will look better. There is no need of the point D also. Now look at this figure. This is the isometric projection of a hexagonal frustum of a hexagonal pyramid, and this is very interesting method that is known as box method. With the help of this method, you can draw isometric projection or isometric view of any of the machine objects also. In next class, I will select a problem on machine drawing. I will take a small machine part and we will draw isometric projection of that. I hope you understand this one. Draw this in your notebook. Thank you. Thank you very much.